Hi students, in this video we are going to see about exercise 11. This is again a small change in treatment of goodwill, which means a goodwill is neither going to be brought in by a new partner nor it is going to be withdrawn. It is actually related to when the goodwill is created, or it is just raised, or it is valued, and it is going to be written off by the all partners in the new profit sharing ratio. So let us observe the question, and then when we are going for preparation of each account, we will come to know what actually are small changes. It's very simple. So let us just observe the question now. A, B and C are partners in a firm sharing profit and losses in the ratio of 4:3:3. So here, so far we had come across only two partners as old, but this time we have three partners as old partners. So and their old ratio is 4:3:3. So this is the thing which we need to keep in our mind, because we have the distribution of profits based on the old ratio for the old partners. So going for the balance sheet, it is just similar again. On the asset side, we have debtors with less provision of the last years, and then going for the adjustment on 1st April 2017, they are admitting a new partner called as D into the partnership on the following terms. So let us see what are the terms and conditions among them which is agreed upon. D is bringing, that is, he brings 50,000 as his capital. So here only capital is given as a first. So this is affecting only in partners capital account. Moving on to the next, second adjustment, we have goodwill account is created. Observe, I have underlined what actually to be required and observed. It is highlighted with an orange color. Now just observe, goodwill account is created for 64,000 and agreed to write off by all partners in the new profit sharing ratio, that is 6:9:9:8. So the new partner is getting admitted, he is bringing 15,000 as a capital. He is not bringing any value towards goodwill, but instead they have created an account. The company has created an account and they have agreed upon among all the partners to write off in the new profit sharing ratio. So in this case, as a small change, that how we are going to prepare the goodwill account. Next, moving on to the next adjustment, we have reduced stock by 10%. Reduce in the sense the stock value is completely decreased. So this is going to be on the debit side of your revaluation account. Next, increase building 269,000. Observe, when the word 2 is given, only the difference has to be treated. You have to compare this with the book value. So 69,000 is going to be the market price, whereas your book value is 60,000. So it is increased. This difference of 9,000 should be taken on the revaluation account credit side. Next, provision for doubtful debts decreased by, which is reduced, your burden is reduced by 2,000. It is going to be a kind of benefit for us. So we are going to take this on the credit side of your revaluation account. So in revaluation account, we have only two adjustments and it is very simple and easy. So let us see how we are going to prepare this. So let us start. Now observe the revaluation account. I have already done this. So let us just observe once. The first adjustment related to your revaluation is reduced stock by 10%. So I have taken two stock reduced. On the debit side, 80,000 is a book value into 10%. I get 8,000. Next, moving on to the next item, it's increased building to 69,000. So there is an increase in the asset. So it is on the credit side taken up by me. 69 is a market price, whereas the book value is 60,000. So the difference amount of 9,000 is increased. I've taken on the credit side. Then PDD decreased by 2,000. There is no comparison when the word buy is given, because they have informed us that it is a benefit by 2,000. So we need not compare it. So I've taken directly the 2,000 on the credit side. See, this is very simple, which we need to understand it. So I have given the note, important note to be remembered by everyone when you're preparing this admission of a partner, how you have to treat the PDD. So just observe that in the previous video. Next, coming up now, we are going to see which side is greater. I guess it is on the credit side. It is observed that on the credit side, we get 11,000. So the same 11,000 is going to be taken up by me on the debit side now. So I've taken 11,000 on the debit side. Now from 11,000, we have to find out what is the difference among the balancing figure which we get as a profit. So I'm going to take it 11,000 minus 8,000. So I get a profit on revaluation as 3,000. So this is going to be transferred to old partner's capital account. This is going to be distributed among the old partners. Now just observe who are the partners here. A 3000 into 4 by 10, then B 3000 into 3 by 10, and C is 3000 into 3 by 10. Now we are going to find out what is the actual value each partners are receiving. So let me check. 3000 into 4 by 10, I guess 1200 in case of A, then for B 3000 into 3 by 10 gives 900 for B and for C as well. For C as well we get 900, because the ratio is same in case of B and C. Once when you calculate for B, the same will be for C. So now just observe, the total should be equal to 3,900 plus 900 is 1,800 plus 1,200 gives us 3,000, which is equal. Now let me highlight it so it's easy for us when we are doing partners capital account. So this is actually to be observed by us, and something is left out. I have forgotten to mention the profit transferred. So your profit transferred is done now. So this is the first step which we are going to complete with revaluation account. Just observe. Let me make it visible. Yes, now revaluation account is completely visible overall. It's very simple. I guess it's easy for you people. I need not explain it. Yes, now let us move on to the goodwill account. Now coming for the goodwill account, just observe. Now, in the goodwill account, the important thing which we need to concentrate is adjustment to goodwill is created. It is not being brought. He is not bringing it. It is created. So when the word created is given, go for the debit side. Here directly write to is each partner's capital account, is capital account, because we are creating it. Then to B's capital account, then to C's all old partners capital account we are going to create and post it. Now I have done this on the debit side. Just observe, when it is created, always when the word created, raised or valued is given, you are not going to go for the credit side, because the word bring or brought is not given. So we are going to directly create on the debit side of each old partner's capital account and just transfer the value of goodwill. It is going to be 64,000 given. So I'm going to just take it and created now. 64,000 into, what is the ratio given, 4 by 10 for first partner, then 64,000 into 3 by 10 for the second partner, and for the third 64,000 into 3 by 10. So now this value is going to be calculated and written by us. So 64,000 into 4 by 10 gives you 25,600 for cap that is partner A, and 64,000 into 3/10 gives 19,200, and the same is going to be for C as well, 19,200. Now let us check whether this is going to be the same. Now I'm going to take the total of debit side. So I get 64,000. So our calculation is right. So we have done this. That is, the goodwill account is created on the debit side. Now they have given in the question, just observe the question. They have given and agreed to write off by all partners. It is by all partners. Write off by all partners in the new profit sharing ratio. Just concentrate on new profit sharing ratio. Now this is going to be written off. So what we are going to do on the credit side, observe, on the credit side, we are going to write it off among all the partners, including the new partner. Now let us create it. Just going to copy and paste. Okay. Control paste. Okay. Now on the credit side, we are going to write off among all the partners, including the new partner. So now this is by A's capital account, then by B's capital account, then by C's capital account, and then by D's capital account. Just observe. Now the same 64,000 is going to be taken up by us, and it is going to be written off, write off in the new ratio. 6 divided by. So let us check what actually is the total of the new ratio. 32. 6 divided by 32. Then 64,000 into 9 divided by 32, then 64,000 into 9 divided by 32, and 64,000 into 8 divided by 32. So this is going to be the ratios. All the partners on the credit side. Now we are going to calculate and check what actually the value is going to be taken up by us. So 64,000 into 6 by 32, 12,000 for partner A, then 64,000 into 9 by 32, 18,000 for partner B and C, then 64,000 into 8 by 32, 16,000 is for partner D. Now observe, let me make it clear. When the goodwill is created, valued or raised, take it on the debit side and distribute among the old partners in their old ratio. If it is going to be written off, okay, it is written off in the sense including the new partner in the new ratio on the credit side, you are going to distribute and show it. That's it. Now we are going to check up what is the total on the credit side. If it is going to be equal, then our calculation is correct. So we got at 64,000. Now just observe, goodwill account is completed. It is raised on the debit side, or it is created on the debit side, or valued on the debit side, and it is written off among all the partners on the credit side. This is very important thing which we need to observe. Now let us move on to the preparation of partners capital account. Just observe and let me make it smaller. Yes, just observe partners capital account is, I guess it's visible. Yes, now moving on to partners capital account, first step is we have to fill the names of all the partners. So it is going to be A, then B, and then C. Now we have one more partner increased, right? So let me insert. Okay, it's going to be B, C, and D. On the credit side, we have created. Now on the debit side, A, B, C, and D. We have also entered the partners' names. Just observe. First, let us move on to the credit side of partners' capital account. Now, first thing is from the opening, let us from the balance sheet, from the last year's balance sheet, is it clear and visible? Yes, from the last year balance sheet, we are going to take up the capitals of the old partners now by balance brought down. It's going to be posted on the credit side. Only the postings now which we are going to do. So it's going to be 40,000 in case of A, B is 50,000, and C is 60,000. D is going to be bought in the form of cash, that is later. Then first step is done. Then we have reserve from the liability side of balance sheet, reserve account. We are going to distribute this. What is the reserve value? 32,000 at their ratios 4:3:3. So we are going to calculate this and we are going to write it among all the partners. So for first A, 32,000 into 4/10 gives me 12,800. Then for B and C, 32,000 into 3/10, 9,600 and 9,600. So we have done now the posting of reserve as well. Then moving on, do we have any profit and loss? No, we have to just check for these three. First is opening capital, then reserve, then you have P&L account. Okay, we have only two items here. Next, moving on to your, we have to concentrate on preparation of the other accounts. Revaluation account, we have the profit transferred on the debit side. This is going to be posted on the credit side by revaluation account. Okay, what is the profit? 1200, 900 and 900. Yes, we have done this. So let me mention it, profit transferred. Now revaluation profit is transferred. Yes, then moving on to the goodwill account, debit side first, what was created, we are going to post it now on the credit side by goodwill account. of each partner 25,600 for A, 19,200 for B, and 19,200 for C. This is over. Now it is written off, right, on the credit side of goodwill account. Now just observe here, A, B, C, and D. My cursor, which is moving. So this is on the credit side. I'm going to post it on the debit side of partners' capital account. 2. Goodwill account. Wherever the capital name is getting affected, that should be posted to the concerned account now. 12,000 for A. Then B and C is 18,000. 18,000, and for D it is 16,000. Just observe once: 12,000 for A, 18,000 for B and C, and D is 16,000. So we have done this now. Just have a look. We have done all the postings: opening capital, reserve, profit on revaluation, goodwill, written off. It's done. We have to take up D's. Just observe the new partner's capital in the question. 50,000 he brings. This is the only thing which is left out, so we're going to take it on the credit side by affecting cash slash bank account. So let me take it as cash or bank. Okay, so this is going to be 50,000 brought in by D. So we have done this. Now we are going to check up what is the balancing figure of partner's capital. So finding out the credit side total of each partner now. 79,600 for A, 79,700 for B, 89,700 for C, and 50,000 for D. Just observe. The total is on the credit side 79,600, 79,700, 89,700, and 50,000. Now the same is going to be taken up by us on the debit side. 89,700, 79,700, 79,600. So now from this total, we are going to find out what is the balancing figure. So let us check. So now we got the balancing figure of cash. It is the balancing figure of partner's capital account. 67,600, 61,700, 71,700, and 34,000. So just observe here in the question, it is the same. Capital A, then the capital of B, and the capital of C, and the capital of D is. So what we have done, the steps is just perfect. So we have completed with partner's capital account. Now let me show the full screen of this. Just observe. Yes, now it's visible. It's completely visible. Yes, the whole partner's capital account is visible now. So this is a step which we need to follow. It's very simple, just posting. See, in case of capital account, cash account, just postings. So concentrate on this. Once when you try, this will help you to do more and more exercises on your own. Yes, now let us move on to the cash account, preparation of cash account. So going for the cash account, first step which we to concentrate is on the assets, cash at bank, opening balance. So I'm going to just take it directly. So the value is given as 17,000 in the question. So I'm going to take it. 17,000 is opening balance. After that, moving on to the revaluation. Always check whether you have or not. You just have to look into that. In revaluation, we don't have any cash getting affected now. Let us concentrate only on this. Next, in goodwill, so there is no cash getting affected. Yes, then moving on to the partner's capital account. In partner's capital account, we have only on the credit side the new partner's capital getting affected. It is on the credit side, post on the debit side. To these capital account, the value which he is bringing is 50,000. Apart from this, there is no other cash getting affected. So we're going to close the cash account now. It's only on the debit side we have, so it is 67,000 the total which we get. The same is going to be taken on the credit side as well, 67,000. And this 67,000 is going to be the same balancing figure, as there is no adjustment on the credit side. So this is a balancing figure which we get. So cash account is also completed. Now just observe. Let me show the cash account. Just observe. Opening balance, D's capital, only two items we found. So that is going to be taken as a total on the debit side. The same total is transferred to the credit side, and the same value is taken as a balancing figure, as there is no adjustment on the credit side. Now we have completed with the cash account. Let us move on to the balance sheet and see how it is going to be prepared by us. Now coming for the balance sheet, new balance sheet. Let us first do it on the asset side. Let us complete on the asset side. Let me minimize it. So first we are going to go for the asset values. First is given us cash at bank. So what is the cash at bank value? That is a cash account balancing figure which is given as 67,000. Take it in the outer column directly. This we know as commonly, which we are doing now, bills receivable. Next item, we have no adjustment, so I'm going to take it directly to the outer column. So what is the bills receivable value? 19,000, which is given in the question. I'm going to take it. Then after the debtors, we have an adjustment, so let me take the value in the inner column. 120,000 less we have PDD. So here the opening, that is the last year's value, is 6,000 minus we had a decrease of 2,000 this year in the revaluation which we took on the credit side. Always observe, if the debtors, that is provision, is on the credit side, you should minus it in case of balance sheet. If it is on the debit side, you should add it, because increase will be a burden additionally increased. Decrease or reduce, in the sense your burden is reduced, you should always minus. So we get 4,000 to be taken up, and the adjusted value is 1,20,000 minus 4,000, 1,16,000 is the value which we get. Yes, now after that we have stock to be taken up now. So stock value, stock we have again adjustment. So 80,000, I'm taking it in the inner column. Then we have less decrease 10% of that 8,000. So the value which I get is 72,000 as adjusted. So stock is completed. Then after stock, what do we have next? Buildings. Buildings again we have an adjustment. It's increase. So 60,000 is going to be the opening. That is a book value. You should write add increase value from the revaluation amount. Always take the amount. So the total is 69,000. That is equal to your market price. This is very clear because it is increased. So your present market price of building is 69,000. Yes. Apart from this, any other adjustment left out, we have taken all. So we get asset value is 343,000, which is equal to the printout given in the question. Yes, on the asset side it is correct. Now let us move on to the liability part and check whether we are going to get the same. So on the liability side of the question, we get creditors. Creditors first, so there's no bills payable. So creditors value is 1 lakh, no adjustment. I'm going to take it directly. After that, we have bank overdraft. So I'm going to take that. Bank OD. Bank overdraft, no adjustment. I'm going to take it directly in outer column. Now we are going to move towards the capital of all the partners A, B, C and D. Now each partner's capital we are going to take from the partner's capital account is observed 67,600. Then 61,700. Then C 71,700. And D is 50,000. Just observe, I have highlighted here in green color. 34,000. So just check, don't blindly take D's capital brought in because we have an adjustment of goodwill written off even for D as well. 34,000. Now the total of this we are going to check here. So the total capital, the new capital is 2,35,000. Now just observe the balance sheet. Let me maximize it. The balance sheet is completed by us and both the side total is tallied equally. It's very simple, students. Only thing is your interest to observe and to listen is very important. And I would also like to give you people a small tips of how to concentrate and listen to the video. See, it's very difficult when you people are listening on online, viewing the channel and the videos. It's very difficult. Your eyes might get affected. You can't sit or you can't see for over a long time. Instead, just on it. Keep your headsets. Okay, don't observe the screen. Instead, take the question. Take the question of that. I shall also put the link of the question PDF के वे यू गेट आई शेल पुट इट इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बिलो सो यू कुड क्लिक ऑन टू दैट डाउनलोड द कम्प्लीट पी डी एफ एंड गो फॉर द क्वेश्चन टेक द जेरोक्स ऑफ दैट ओके यू हैव टू सिट विद द हेडसेट एंड जस्ट लिसन Seeing the question with a hard copy and start trying by yourself only by listening to this video. Moreover, if you have a doubt, you can see the steps. Because if you're just looking into this for a long and longer time, it will not help you. It will only put you into like, you know, you're losing your interest somewhere. So I just want you people to try this method. So have a break, relax yourself and again come back. So each and every, once you have completed one account, take a break. Then concentrate on the second account. So you have a break for each and every account. So it will help you to do better and learn better. You shall have so much of interest and later on it will become a practice. Clear? Yeah, thank you.